episode 1581, When Your Children Outsmart You.
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people drive. Happy, happy day. I am so excited because it's Friday. Yes, you made it through the week, and it is Confessions of an Upset Mama. Are you feeling a little bit kind of frazzled? I don't know. Sometimes on Fridays, I feel crazy, but it's a good crazy and a bad crazy all wrapped up in one. What happens when your children outsmart you? Let's dive in. For those of you who are brand new to Create You Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, growing up, you think you're smarter than your parents. I know I did. And at times, yes, I'm sure they put me in my place. But what can you do when your children outsmart you as the parent? Getting older isn't fun. Wrinkles, less energy, oh, saggy. Well, we'll keep that for a secret just for a little while. But with aging, one would expect wisdom to accompany age. Sounds reasonable. However, parenting is nothing but reasonable. You have to expect the unexpected and brace for the impact at all turns and at all times. Now that my children are on the brink of young adulthood, you know, we got those high schoolers now, a senior and a freshman, and I've got the college students plus the graduates. Yes, thank you, Lord. Their wisdom is increasing. And mine? Well, there are days that I feel like a toddler. They are teaching me about so much. Even the classes they're taking, I took too, yet I fumble my way through helping them with their studies. When did I get old? When did my children start learning more than me? Some parents would be quick to defend their own expertise. Never can a parent be wrong. I'm never wrong. Or never can we fall short of perfection. I'm always right. Parenting seems to be the rite of passage to knowledge and wisdom. But what happens when your child outsmarts you? Now, it's not that bad when they're just there and they kind of let you say whatever and all is well. But when the bull comes out of the china cabinet, the battle is on. Children can challenge your knowledge and force your hand. And with their growing expertise, they learn how to challenge you, fair or not. We as parents can be quick to fight back. And we want to put on those boxing gloves because you know what? We want to be number one. Or we can stimulate their leadership capabilities. That is your Kiss the Keep It Simple strategy. Stimulate your child's leadership role. Knowledge doesn't have to be the I am right, you are wrong argument. Yet we all seem to kind of fall that direction. You don't always have to be the one who knows your stuff. Children who openly express their opinions and knowledge are fluffing their leadership potential. If they can go up against you, imagine the impact they can make on the world. And who doesn't need more qualified leaders in our world today? So instead of always having to be right and keeping score as a parent, let go of your scoreboard. Drop it, tear it up, and stimulate your child's leadership role. What does that look like? Well, number one, you have to build confidence. Build confidence in your child. They look up to you as much as they may argue with you. They may not like you. They may yell at you at times. They may throw temper tantrums. But guess what? They look up to you. You have the key in building their confidence up. Open their eyes up to their own potential. They have to see themselves shine under pressure. And yes, parents, we place a huge amount of pressure on our children, no matter how hard we try not to. I know for me growing up, my dad always wanted me to go to the, you know, extra nth degree, so to speak. And he would push me. And I know when I wanted to start playing an instrument, it wasn't just piano lessons, but it was flute. And he said, if you're going to get a flute and you're going to play that instrument, you're going to practice an hour a day. When I thought about that, I was like, an hour a day? Seriously? when I first started out, how many notes can I play? And he would tell me stories about how he had to practice and what he did. And I was like, I really don't want to do that. But guess what? I started doing it little bits at a time. And I would practice at least an hour a day. Hence, I've been given incredible compliments and opportunities regarding my flute. I put the work in. And guess what? He helped build that confidence up. Not necessarily what I thought was great at the time. I kind of wanted to badmouth him every once in a while. Never to his face, of course, never. And I was always respectful to my father. But underneath my breath, I'd be like, seriously, Dad, do I have to do this again? We as parents, we put pressure on our children. We want what's best for them. We want what we didn't get or better than what we had. And so we push them, even though we don't really want to or mean to. So we have to look and say, okay, how can I build confidence in my child? Open up their eyes to their own potential. See what they cannot see. Number two, refine the hesitancies. Where do they question themselves? These hesitancies are areas you can help shore up and support. It's the foundation. Think about this. Where do we fall? Where we are weak. You are taking the weaker muscles and making them stronger. So the areas where they question, like, oh, I'm just not good at this, whatever this is, help them refine those hesitancies, build them up, build that great foundation for them. So guess what? When they do fall, the fall isn't as long. And finally, number three, celebrate the milestones. We're great at celebrating our children when they first start to walk, when they say dada for the first time or mama, when they ride their bike, when they can play their first note on their instrument. We celebrate all of those things. When they can write their name all by themselves without us helping them. But we forget that there's milestones in leadership, in growing up. It's not about just doing things and saying, oh, I can check this off for my child. It's about their influence, their knowledge, their growth of wisdom. When we are growing, both in knowledge and leadership, key peaks will be conquered along the way. Some huge, very quick to recognize, and others, oh, so small and tiny that we may miss the pebble on the very top. But with each step, your child is spreading his or her wings and growing into a productive and influential individual. This is where you can stand proud as a parent. You broke the bowl in the china cabinet and stimulated your child's leadership role. For that, I applaud you. You see, parenting, it's not about being the I am right, you are wrong. It's not about being the parent who fluffs only their own feathers. Parenting is recognizing when it's time to pass the belief torch to your child. Are you at that point in your child's life that they need to be handed the belief torch? You need to be their inspiration more than telling them how many chores that they haven't finished, more than pointing out how wrong they were doing a particular math problem, reminding them not to talk back or reminding them to say thank you and please. We need to take our belief torch and pass it on to our children and build them up in their leadership roles. It goes a long way. And no, we are not sitting around thinking about this. But we as parents, we need to start thinking about this. If you're mentoring a child, you need to start thinking about this. You need to be aware of your influence beyond your knowledge and your wisdom. That bowl in the china cabinet, it's a young child waiting to spread his or her wings. They have incredible potential. Imagine how your heavenly Father looks down at you. Think about how many mistakes that you've made, yet he says, my child, you are incredible. I created you. You have a purpose. Now go, run with it. We are to do the same for our child. Your child is a gift to you. And whether or not you have children, you're an influence to children around you, the world that you touch. Be a mentor. be a leader in their lives to what? To develop leadership within their own lives. It's time to pass that belief torch on. Your family matters to me. And you're so important that if this is an area where you're going, gosh, I get what you're saying, but in the real world of my life, it doesn't make sense to me. I'm getting ready for the day and then it just seems to all go downhill. I need help with this. I want to come beside you and assist you where you are in your journey right now. I have a gift for you. It's a free coaching call with me. It's an opportunity for you to experience number one life coaching. A lot of people have no idea what coaching is all about and the power within it. And if you're saying, I would like to do more when it comes to my parenting, my leadership, so I too can pass on the belief torch to my child, click on the link, take aim in the show notes, and that will begin our conversation. Remember, it's not about I am right, you are wrong. When your children begin to outsmart you, it's a sign of what? Growth and maturity. That should put a smile not only on your face, but in your heart. Continue to build up an incredible generation. For one step at a time leads to your miles of greatness. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a wonderful, beautiful weekend. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.